Right. So this is the current modification for the circuit. 10 kilo, 22 microfarads, without the diode, directly on the signal pin there, is what you are seeing here. And I hooked up, this is for minus, and this is the plus, which I took it from the signal here. This is where I put the probe on Eric's, on that leg of that resistor. It's what you are seeing there. It's happening. So directly from the pin, I took the voltage directly, and then directly to the minus. And here we have the multimeter. I hope I can focus like that. So if I'm doing this, I get 1.6 instead of 1.5 for some reason. I'm not sure why. Okay, but I'm filming this because I want to show you something. I just did a test with the remote control, and if I'm doing this, watch the voltmeter. And also this, guys, it is commutating. Is how you said, is if it's 3 volts, will switch, and it is switching around 3 volts, 3.5 or something. If you keep an eye here on the voltmeter, if I'm clicking tick 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 tick, 3.5, something like that. You can also see how fast is moving the LEDs. I'm not sure why it's doing this, because I'm not. Let's see. You see? It's but it's. You see, is having its own mind. Probably that capacitor. Who knows? But it's interesting. I like it. It's switching. That's interesting. It's switching there. Of course, I didn't link it to the sensing circuit. We will first make that work and then link it to this in the same time. Make probably a board, separate board, because if I'm keeping it on the breadboard here, I'm sure when I will take it out from there and put it on its own module, it will behave a little bit different. I hope not, but usually they behave differently. And 3.65, and that is red, and 1 and 10 pin are on at this point. That's it. Okay, I hope it will help you.